Hello. So, we are discussing on computer network and internet protocols. Today, we will be looking at layer 1 of the OSI or in TCP IP model, that is the physical layer. So, rather a couple of lectures we will be discussing on physical layer phenomena. Though in some of the literature on in several standards, some of the standards they consider physical and data link as a single layer, like if you put the NIC card, it comes with the both the things. And though again the physical layer, as you will see, is more related to the so to say quote unquote electronics and communication perspective, nevertheless we need to understand that physical layer basic philosophy, which allows me to carry the traffic from one network to another network and type of things. So, as we discussed several times, that any upper layer phenomena needs a lower layer to communicate. That means, unless the lower layer is there, it is not able to do it, it is not able to communicate. And end of the thing is the physical layer. There should be a physical connectivity between the source and the destination, or in our cases the physical connectivity between two hops. So, whether it is wired, wireless, it based on the technology, nevertheless, or fiber or whatever, but nevertheless I require a physical connectivity. And there are several considerations, like what should be the encoding scheme, because finally whatever we are doing with the system or the at the end systems are generated digital signals, right? But your communication path may not be suitable to carry that digital signals, right? So in that case, you need to convert this digital to some sort of analog and then communicate and do a other way around. Who will do that, right? Who will provide the physical infrastructure to work on the thing, work on this communication path, right? I buy a laptop, then I want to communicate with the rest of the world, right? Through say mail, chat, browsing and type of things, right? Either in an interactive mode, or either I read or write type of things, right? Now, in order to do that, I need to a connection to the overall networking cloud, right? Or overall this internet. How do I connect? So, one the best way at the home what we are using is using the mobile data network. So, what you are doing? You are using the mobile as a hub, right? Or hotspot, or Wi-Fi hotspots, or a type of things, then you connect to the mobile, your device, mobile device from your laptop, and that in turn use the back end data network to connect to the internet, right. So, this is something which is need to be connected or physically connected. Whatever your protocol and whatever you are working at the upper layer, this thing is needed, right. Or you can connect your PC or laptop through a cable if you are having a connection in your office with RJ45 through a cable. So, that is a physical connectivity. In turn, that point is connected to a switch, in turn to the backbone network and so on and so forth, right. So, what we require at our end, at the device end, is a network interface card. The NIC typically takes care of both your data link layer phenomena, or more to say MAC layer phenomena, and the physical layer standard, whether it is having a wireless connectivity, whether it is having a fiber connectivity, whether it is having a coaxial connectivity or a RJ45 Ethernet cable connectivity, that is decided by your NIC card. So, NIC card has those interfaces, right? And then you can connect to the rest of the world, the physical connectivity will be there. So, that is the physical connections what is there. Lot of things goes on, and it is a very complicated, not only complicated, it is a very complex communication procedure which goes on, which is under the purview of communication. So, it would not be possible to deal with all communication phenomena, but we will try to hit on those important stuff. So, today we are trying to see that what makes this overall process works together, and then slowly in next one or two lectures we will see that what are the basic features which we need to understand when we are looking at a computer network or protocol stack in following some standards. Now, the picture which is available in several literature, also we have seen in at the beginning of this lecture series. So, what we see at the end, we have this physical layer which is mostly responsible for transmission of binary data through a medium, right? Very straightforward and simple, right? So, if you go up, if you have transfer of input frames, etcetera, then delivery model for network layer and so on and so forth, right? So, physical layer is concentrated with the things. Medium may be WAD, wireless, or any medium which allows to communicate, right? So, this is the down the layer OSI thing. Again, I am repeating, in case of TCP/IP, some of the cases we consider these two as a single thing. In some cases, the physical layer is kept apart because it is more of a communication phenomenon. Nevertheless, it requires for to communicate. Now, two things are coming whenever we are discussing, two stuff is coming. One is communication. Let us put it as a data communication, because we are looking as we are trying to look at data, where would it communicate. Another aspect is a networking, right? Or other means the what we do once the communication is there. So, data communication, as we see, transmission of signals in a reliable, effective manner. So, one to transform one node to another node. So, that is the way what we look at the data communications, and it involves signal transmission, transmission media, signal encoding, interfacing with different transmission media, and interfacing with the NIC card with the transmission media and type of things, and multiplexing and so on and so forth. So, these are the different aspects which are there with the data communication, whereas the networking, it mostly deals with technology, architecture, protocols, protocol of communication networks used to interconnect communicating devices or entities or endpoints or intermediate points per se. So, it's the technology, there should be architecture and the protocol or what we say standards, so that the two devices can communicate, right? Here mostly what we have seen topics like LAN, WAN, networking protocols of different levels, routing, and at the network level there are transport level communication TCP or UDP, there are communication at the, and finally, we have network applications which talk to peer-to-peer communications, right. So, these are mostly concentrated in the networking. What it assumes in when we work on the network, we assume that the underlining media is there, right. When you try to browse a particular site, or do some networking related operations with your systems, PC or laptop, what we assume that the physical media is there, right? Or there is a physical communication is there. So, these are the two aspects, and again in the literature you will find that when we see, so we have a source where the data is generated, there should be something which is a transmitter, then a transmitter carries the thing to a transmission systems, right? Then at the other end, I have a receiver and the destination which are there, right? So, this way the source to destination is there. If it is a full duplex or both way communication, then there should be a communication pathway and the destination source, when it acts as a source, and this is the destination. So, what we have this thing, one is the source, right? Typically, PC or laptop can be a source. A transmitter, there are some devices which allows me to transmit to the backbone of the network. then the transmission systems, it can be internet or it can be a rather I should say that can be a some sort of a communication system. Like the most prevalent communication system what we are having is the telecom network, right. So, the internet with the backbone as the telecom network, and then we have other things, right. There is a word called modem coming into picture, we will see in coming one or two slides that what is there, and that the other end of the computer. So, I have some way to communicate with the things, right. It can be a mobile device, by these systems connect to this say particular mobile device, and then this in turn has the data network at the backbone, and then the data traffic goes on. It can be like this. The system, my system can have a RJ, a particular Ethernet cable which is connected to the wall mounted socket, which is in turn connected to the backbone layer 2 network or backbone layer 2 switch or the layer 2 switch of our IIT Kharagpur network, which in turn connect to a hierarchy of switches, finally goes to the gateway to go out of that particular network, right. If it is required, or if it is within the same switch network, then it does whatever is there to be do in a layer 2 switching, right. So, that is the way is there. So, there is some devices which allows me to push the network things. And if we look at the communication tasks, there is a variety of things. Some of them are listed: transmission, system utilization, interfacing, or rather than utilization, I should say transmission system. Utilization is definitely another aspect, transmission system, utilization, interfacing, signal generation, synchronization of the things. Once we communicate, there should be a way of synchronization. There is a exchange management, or there should be a, when we exchange the thing, there should be an inherent management things, like I send a data, I get an acknowledgement and type of thing. Error detection and correction mechanisms, if there is an error, how to recover from the error. Addressing and routing, how to the route packets, recovery from a particular failed situation, message formattings, and other aspects which come into play, though it not directly may not be possible to do cover those things, but what we plan that at least one, if possible two lectures, we will talk on network security aspects, right? Because this is becoming extremely important. So, what are the different aspects of network security that we will try to see? So, that is also a thing. And then we have a network management, overall network management process to handle the things. So, these are the different aspects of communication tasks, or so to say computer data communication components, right. So, it is a when we do looking at the data communication aspects of it. So, we have two type of things. One is a local area network or LANs, right. So, there are several protocols which are predominantly for the LANs. We will see that there is a basic consideration for LAN. Another category is a WAN, wide area network, which is connected to the internet. Typically, what we see, these LANs are pretty high speed things, like you get a backbone of a connectivity of 1 Gbps connection, etcetera, through your system, provided your NIC card supports that, right. But 100 Mbps is very common, is the de facto thing for communicating in the things. Whereas, if you look at your other side of the router, getting a Gbps links is pretty costly, right. So, means to the tune of order of 100 Mbps are also costly to maintain. So, that means in other sense, the LAN connectivity is much higher than the backbone or the internet router level connectivity. So, and if we look at the source and transmitter are together we put in the source itself, like your NIC card is sitting on your system itself. So, the both the transmitting and the typically the source of the data are together. So, what we typically see, you have the source which is having source data source and the transmitter, you have the destination which has the receiver and the destination for the data, right, and intermediate thing is the transmitted media. and we'll try to see that what are the different consideration for this transmission media for in one or two lectures. So what is the predominant things what we are having is the telephone network, right? So that is the something which is omnipresent when the communication network coming into play. So this is very much there, this telephone network, and what we see rather it is what we say basic telephone network. What rather we see there are not only there can be different parties which are there, right? There are different telecom companies or telcos which are in your serving in your area or serving in your region, state, country and type of things, right? So these telecom operators are primarily started for voice communication, but now they graduated to a scenario of to data communication, rather streaming data type of thing. So voice, data, multimedia along with mobility, right? So this sort of communication are happening into the things, right? Definitely we have devices which can talk to each other using these things. There are one thing coming to play immediately, that these different telcos should be able to communicate with each other. That means there should be interoperability between different telecom companies, right? Or if you look at our things, that mobile service providers, there should be some way how they communicate with each other. So that is one important aspect. Now, if I can put somewhere other my data network or my data communication paradigm enter this telecom cloud, then at least the backbone communication I can ensure with their data communication, right? And if you practically see, it's a huge infrastructural investment when you go for this sort of a thing, right? It's a huge infrastructural investment when things are there, right? If we look at the thing. So we can utilize the things. What we require some connectivity with this thing, with your system or your network or your organization network to the nearest telecom center, or what we say nearest exchange, right? If you are an organization, right? When we use as an individual, then my system should be able to communicate to my network. Suppose I have a BSNL or Airtel or Vodafone or something, Reliance and etcetera connections. What I require is the how I communicate to that system, to the their backbone telecom network. Once that is there, then the connectivity, everybody is connected, things are there, right? So another thing, as we are discussing, so there is usually our communication path are analog, right? Where or wireless, audio tones, info conveyed through a signal amplitude frequency phase or analog signaling, right? Whereas the working of our system, etc., are primarily digital or ones and zeros. So what is the problem happening? You are basically generating a series of zeros and one needs to communicate through a media which understands that analog signal. So you are generating a digital signal, but need to be pumped through a media which understands it analog signal, right? Consider our that previously how we used to communicate. There is a, many of you might have not seen that. So there was landline, still it is there, through the landline phone cables. There is a device we used to connect, and that device connects to this system or the computer. When we used to communicate, we communicate this through this. So this device is typically a modem, right? Or what we say, a modulator and demodulator. So the modem at the source end or one end is does that modulation signal, getting a binary set, it modulate and pumped into the analog backbone which understand analog, that is carried to the other end of the signal, and then it is again demodulated and push it to the end system. So the two system talks each other at the physical layer itself, they communicate, that one is modulation another is demodulation at the other end, right. So, that two terms we call it as a modem. So, it is like this, I have an analog network, it can be a phone or type of the cloud itself. So, the digital signal through the modem goes to this analog and goes out, right. So, this analog to the another end, while at the end system it is the other way around, right. So, that is a very effective device, and we could able to easily connect. It is not there are a lot of other hindrances like your call drops, like it goes disconnected, etcetera. Nevertheless, the phenomena is straightforward. You need to have a modem at your disposal, which connects to the rest of the network, where at the other end also somebody who is communicating is having another modem, and so forth. So, what we do effectively? So, we have a system through a modem, it communicates to this basic network and communicates here again a modem and a basic system, right, and a computing system. So, I can use these backbone network or the backbone telecom network to communicate with the two systems, right. So, using modulator and demodulator or modem. Now, if we look at the modem, modem translate the digital computer signal to analog signal, which are which the telecom network or the telephone backbone understands and carry it to the destination and vice versa, right. So, that is the way things are there, and there is a like what we have that plain old telephony systems or the ports, so or telephony service, that is the ports. And then what we this the modem allow is to communicate with these things, right. So, that is the way how we communicate. So, what we see if there are multiple systems need to communicate with the other system, like there is a bunch of system out here which wants to communicate with this, say this is the server at the other end, right. So, there can be a database server, application server, different type of server, different type of clients which wants to communicate with this server, and for that what we require individual lines to communicate with the things, right. So, to say if I am communicating from distance, say modem 1, modem 2, modem 3, modem 4 and communicating with the things, or even it is communicating with a WAD mesh to connect, means a WAD connectivity from the source and destination. Now, this becomes a cumbersome process if multiple things are there. So, we have a concept, there is a concept in the communication called multiplexer or multiplexing, where it allows a multiple signals to be carried across the single physical dimension. So, that is the multiplexing, and if we look at these are there can be different type of things we will discuss in our subsequent lectures. That is, one is time division multiplexing or TDM. Frequency division multiplexing and so forth. So, these are two popular things, and we will see that different variants of the things. Now, so I have different signals which are generated by these different systems, and then we have a multiplexer which multiplex these things, right. And usually this when the single things are communicated, these are through baseband communication, whereas these are through broadband communication. So, apply able to carry single multiple signals simultaneously. In a baseband, it carries only one signal, right. So, this is the way it is there. So, I have broadband because there are multiple signals. So, there are multiple, so those are multiplex using some technology, and that has become communicated to a broadband signal. So, just to quickly, though the letters are pretty little small in size, but nevertheless, we just have a quick look at the baseband and broadband. What the baseband said, baseband transmissions typically use digital signaling over a single wire, right. So, that means the transmission themselves take the form of either electrical pulse or light things, or whether it is a what sort of media is there. The digital signal used in baseband transmission occupies the entire bandwidth of the network. bend the network media and transmit a as a single data signal, right. So, typically the baseband multiplexing is the TDM, whereas in case of a broadband uses the analog signal in the form of a optical and electromagnetic waves over multiple transmission frequency. So, I have multiple transmission frequencies or carriers by which these signals are carried. For signal to be both sent and received, the transmission media must be split into two channels. If I have a send receive type of path, then we have a things. That is true for there also, that if you have to both send and receive data using single cable, then that type some sort of a mechanism has to be there. However, the sending and receive can occur on the same wire at the same time. So, either I to have a two separate cable send receives, or some arrangement of doing some sort of a time division multiplexing where multiple things can be shared. So, in case of a broadband also, multiple channels are created by the broadband system for multiplexing technique known as using some a approach for frequency division multiplexing. We will just see those things for in subsequent lecture. So, early communication, so there is a ports and it able to communicate. So, there is a branch office or headquarter or a branch location 1 and location 2. So, it has a some multiplexer, then if I have a modem which communicate to the plain old telephony service, which in turns communicate to other modem to, or this is for modulation 1 end, this is demodulation, and then if there is a multiplexing, so there is a demux and the signals are pumped into the at the server end or the other end. Now, if the multiple locations are there, then we have multiple modem connection and so on and so forth. So, with these things also it is works fine, though the achievable speed is not that high. Secondly, the management etcetera are also challenging, right. So, there are different architecture, different protocols of managing them and type of things, right. Though there are a lot of standardization has occurred. So, these are three locations where these are communicating with the modem at the and then it is communicating to the plain old telephony services or ports framework or ports backbone. So, what we are looking at, that the if we look at the physical layer consideration, one is your NIC or network interface card as we discussed. So, NIC provides both this MAC and the physical layer. As we are discussing, it gives a connect a way to connect through a RJ45 cable or through a wireless media or even through your say coax cable, if it is like that, coaxial cable, if there is prevent. So, to two systems we to connect to computers, what I need to do? Suppose I have two computers, how do I connect? Install NIC at each, right, and then connect the thing, right. I can have a single cable to connect to the two systems, because if my networking is based on these two systems, I do not require something to do that. But it is how there is a small catch that we need to do using a crossover cable. That means, crossover means this trans of this source is receive of other things, and trans of the B is the in the receive cable of the thing. So, it is crossed over to the thing. So, that is a crossover cable, or popularly what we say cross cable, right. We require a cross cable means there is. So, two system can communicate. So, it is considered at the thing. So, this physical connectivity is that through a say RJ45 cable. So, typically this cable can be stretched up to 100 meters or 300 feet. That for faithful reconstruction of things, but in reality we may not able to go that far It is little less than the 100 meter consideration. Otherwise, signal degradation will be much higher to handle that. If it is more, then we require something called a repeater, right? So, a repeater which regenerates the signal. So, that is a repeater can be used to increase the distance. So, if I have a repeater, again the distance is increased, right. So, repeater regenerates the signal. And when we look at the concept of hub, if there are number of points needs to be connected, then we have a hub or multi-port or a sort of a multi-port repeater, right. So, these are the devices which add the which are at the manifestation at the network at the layer 2 or the physical layer. So, any other layer things like instead of the hub, if I have a layer 2 switch, that also works as a signal regenerator and have this physical layer connectivity. So, that instead of hub, I could have a layer 2 switch, or I even can have a layer 3 switch, or where we have the routing or the network level activations, right. So, any upper layer has all the lower layer phenomena, so that is absolutely fine it works with, right. So, another things what we previously also discussed, just to mention again, that see at the layer 1 I am in the same broadcast level or at the same as a thing the same collision domain also. So, as we are in the same collision domain, so the more is the collision or more simultaneously the stations want to exchange information, there will be collision and retransmission of the signal, right. Suppose we consider this a 4 port switch, a 4 port hub of say 100 Mbps for our some argument's sake, right. Now, if the 4 systems are connected, so and they all are communicating at the simultaneously, so there will be huge amount of collision or retransmission of the signal or effective bandwidth will fall, right. So, even if it is a backbone of 100 Mbps, so effectively if or in a worst case situation, we will get a around 25 Mbps, right. So, divided by across the thing. So, the hub, the overall bandwidth is divided by the number of ports or the in type of things. So, that is a as in the same collision domain, right. But the other side is that more you go on the higher devices, more cost increases, right. The hub is the switch is much costlier than hub, layer 2 switch, a layer 3 router is costlier than the a layer 2 switch and so forth as you go on the things, right. So, hubs are good for some very small network or for extending a network and type of things, but may not be that efficient to do that. But our basic consideration is not that immediately finding the overall performance efficiency, but to look at that how to connect systems across, right, at the physical level, right. So, this is the thing. So, what we have seen today is more of looking at the different aspects or of that of at the physical layer or the layer 1, and in our subsequent lecture or what we'll look into some more phenomena, to go a little deep into the some more phenomena of this physical layer, like that including multiplexing and so forth, how they work and type of things, right. So, that is that in subsequent lectures in this. So, with this let us conclude today and for and we will continue in our next class. Thank you.